Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds, Peril on Gorgon. We've got a lot of baddies around, somewhere beyond these doors. Are they up there?
If we've learned anything in our travels, it's that the fancier the facade, the darker the underbelly.
Well, there are things moving around very quickly. Sealed. I don't like it. Oh, the bathroom. Anyone need to use the facilities? I guess now would be the time. Ew. Well, I guess it shouldn't be unexpected, but still. Not sure if I should check. I guess I'll go forward here. Well, so who's destroyed all these mechs? They must be overhead. So many baddies. Is that something? Oh wait. A ring. And a tossball card from Matthew Singh. Have they added tossball cards? Spacer's Choice really got the best when they recruited Singh, a hacker known for his cleaving early in a game. Mm-hmm. And there's another... Oh, that's, like a sign or some kind of neon sign. Alright, let's sell a few things here really quick before we continue. Oh, I'm buying! Ah, damn it. What the hell's wrong with me? Hunting rifle, hyper. Tactical shotgun. Some of the stuff I should store some of the stuff on the ship, actually. That's a pretty good helmet. There's gotta be rope, like androids. I see them like, I saw one like float down or something. I don't know. They're up there somewhere. Just the fact that I can see them on the radar and I don't know where exactly they are kind of increases the, is this something? Wait. No. It increases my, like stress, I guess. Anticipation. Oh, damn it. Wrong button. Okay, what is wrong with me? Stop. That's the problem with playing multiple games at a time. That was moving. You tend to mess up the controls from one to the other. Terra fried spratwurst. Ooh, bugs. Okay, that's this area. Terrified spratwurst. Farm-raised sprat, deboned and finely ground and fried in hot oil. Uses the finest herbs and spices. Try it with double mustard. No thanks. Oh my god, what's wrong with me? I'm buying again. This is just how much stuff I picked up in that kitchen area. Adrenatime. Maybe we can make the mechs friendly? Oh my god. I huffed again. Receptionist desk. Internal access. Welcome, W. McKay. Hmm. Messages. Thank you for using Gimsy blah, 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 from Goodfellow L. Subject, reception procedure and protocol. From Goodfellow L to W. McKay. Or Mackie. After some deliberation, I've decided to update your standard procedure and protocol while you operate the front desk. Commit the following to memory. 1. Do greet visitors and workers with a smile. 2. Do mention Spacer's Choice brand products and services in your daily greetings. 3. Do monitor and report extended lavatory breaks. How long before a lavatory break becomes and crosses the line into extended, right? 4. Don't mention our surveillance and security system to arriving visitors. 5. Don't talk about the incident. 6. Don't let any auditors into the upper floor under any circumstances. Failure to adhere to protocol number 6 will result in a demerit on your permanent record. I don't mean to be harsh with you, McKay. You're part of our family, too. Regards, Lawrence Goodfellow, Management. Hmm. Zubin had a little loose lips there. Door lock controls. Personal memo. No auditors on the upper floors. Orders from Mr. Goodfellow. Unlock showcase. Now, for all we know, that starts letting things down here. I don't know. Guess we'll find out.
They got one for Edgewater! Oh, it's just sold tuna. Come on, we got a volcano too.
Spacer's Choice is unreasonably proud of their low-quality fare, aren't they?
What do we have? Oh, this? These displays you're talking about? You saw them before I did. That might lead upstairs. Adrena time, lightning reflexes, keen skills, more kills. All with Adrena time. I can't get at this. It's behind a screen or something.
Shh.
Don't shush me.
Keep your aim steady and your trigger finger at the ready. Adrena time brings out the hero in you.
Show your boss that you are prime. Because you take Adrena time.
Right. Leave the competition far behind with Adrena time. Wow, I want to get at some of this stuff. Well, looks like we can. At least from a back room. Oh, there's like... looks like an electrical hazard over there.
Proudly located in the bloodstream of the entire Spacer's chosen tossball team. Adrena time. Putting the performance in performance-enhancing drugs.
Show your boss that you are prime, because you take Adrena time.
Productive towns run on Adrena time. That's a cool little 3D map kind of thing.
Don't let sleep rob you of your life. Cut your resting hours in half and double your productivity with Adrena time.
Show your boss that you are prime, because you take Adrena time.
Another door. Okay, this leads to the stairs up. That leads to the back room, so maybe we can check that stuff out. Oh, that's like, that's a separate back room, and this leads back to the case. Alright. So obviously I'm gonna hit this last then. now that I see that. Like a power room. Toughened mod. Okay. This is broken. So my own reflection there. So they both, the doors both go back there. We just take it off there. Champion toss ball stick. Perfect game. Staring at the weapon long enough, you'd swear you could hear the roar of a stadium crowd cheering you on, hungry for more action. Who are you to disappoint your fans? I guess that might be the best toss ball stick or something. Light machine gun Mark III. Okay. Energy canister. I don't know if these things can detect us being upstairs, but just in case. You know what? Screw it. Might as well avail ourselves and not sell things. I mean, not buy things, but sell things. What about all the salt tuna stuff I picked up? Oh, this. Yeah, we don't need this stuff here. Okay. Whoa, I think we got enough Adrena time. Show your boss that you are what does Adrena time do for us anyway, actually? Liquid caffeine with boosters. Movement speed plus 20%. Weapon attack speed, same. Crash, all attributes, minus 1. Walk speed, minus 10%. Yeah, I think I'm going to get rid of all this. I wonder how much weight, 0.10, but this is going to be several pounds. I mean, we have over 200 of these things. So I'm going to get rid of it because I don't use the stuff that has crash attribute to it. So 166 pounds. 143, that helps.
Show your boss that you are prime, because you take a tree at a time.
Okay, fun time's over. About to head upstairs where auditors are not allowed. Floor 2. Inadequately displayed, but understood nonetheless. Yeah, we're definitely on their floor now. Wow, look right over there. There's another level up there. There's at least some up there. I'm sure there's some. There's one right behind that wall, apparently. Hole in the wall. I'm still looking for these things. They found us first. That's why they move around so fast, too. It's the arena time. Maybe this unlocks the safe, you never know. Welcome, see mostly. To El Goodfellow, subject on the latest. Mr. Lawrence Goodfellow, on the latest test results from human inquiry with some additional commentary. Fortuitously, I have had the opportunity to review the latest test results from human inquiry. I agree with your and the committee's general assessment that these test results are unacceptable. The latest experimental sample of Adrena Time demonstrates a 15 out of 17 possible symptoms in my rubric of dangerous, lethal, and otherwise high-risk side effects. I have sent a full report here at desk, the abstract of which is as follows. Adrena Time in its current state fails to meet this project's standards. By my calculations, Adrena Time users trade short-term improvements in productivity for long-time losses in productivity. Specifically, dead workers are unproductive workers. Yeah, I'd say that makes sense. Whenever a calculation produces an unforeseen result, it is prudent to take a look at one's numbers. Incorrect numbers lead to flawed calculations. If the HIA's calculations are sound, then their numbers, that is to say, the drugs provided by Chem Labs, must be flawed. Your esteemed colleague, Mr. Clarence Mosley. Okay, so another one to Goodfellow. Further analysis on the fundamental problem undermining our operations with additional suggestions. I have not yet received your correspondence regarding my previous letter. I can only assume you are still, to deploy a parochial colloquialism, I'll say that five times fast, chewing over my commentary. I have several additional insights which I have collated into an itemized list and sent to your secretary. Here is my summary. I believe the root of the problem lies in the Chem Lab. As I mentioned in my previous letter, incorrect numbers lead to flawed calculations. The problem must therefore be found in Dr. Jasper Lowe and his stewardship of the Chem Lab. Dr. Lowe is a notoriously lackadaisical and careless manager and, pardon my language, a poor scientist. Pardon my language. You said poor. Chem Lab must provide HIA with a safe, high-quality, carefully refined drug with which to conduct tests. This slapdash, artless, high-risk formula Chem Lab has been delivering to HIA can only result in unacceptable test results. I understand that safety and high-quality development, are often antithetical to the corporate strategy of Spacer's Choice, but in my life I have found that the perspective of an outsider can be helpful. Awaiting your response, Mr. Clarence Mosley. And last but not least, encouraging words on the nature and practice of leadership with additional insights. Mr. Lawrence Goodfellow, your response to my previous two letters are conspicuous by their absence, meaning there is no response. Based on my analysis of your personality type, dietary habits, patterns of speech, and mode of dress, I must conclude with reasonable certainty that your silence stems from trepidation and anxiety. Nice to have a psych evaluation based on your patterns of speech and the way you dress and stuff. If I might presume to offer you some advice cultivated after years of living in Byzantium, may I suggest that your anxiety stems merely from ignorance? Ignorance is the easiest of vices to rectify and requires only learning and heeding the advice of one's betters. The success and failure of any project depends on the readiness of its constituent staff to perform their mandated duties. Scientists perform experiments, researchers research, managers manage. When one of these roles acts outside of its limitations, chaos is introduced into the system. Take heart. You need not fear the burden of management. The secret of good leadership is strong oversight combined with careful, fastidious, numerically driven, and scientifically supported management. The turbulence experienced by this project is emphatically not the fault of the OCI. However, it is the role and duty of the OCI to fix these problems. Ours is the only department capable of righting the ship of innovation in the waters of chaos. With paternal affection, Mr. Clarence Mosley. Stop shushing me. So, what we got here are messages. I can open this easily. Correction, I am in. I don't know what I'm doing here. Okay. I think I have my keys reversed for crouch and speed. Not speed, sprint. Let's take a quick look at what I have here. So I have Hulking Cranial Helmet, 89. What's even better? Reshaped Power Helmet. This helmet has been modified by the last marauder who wore it. It looks sturdy, but it smells. I don't want something that smells, but... let me air it out a little bit and... isn't this my armor rating? Oh, I guess that's, like, my base. So, someone else can get this 84 and 89. Oh, yeah. 68. And 77. Oh, yeah. Can't take it off, but I can replace it, I guess. How do I... I've forgotten this. Oh, I just go into the inventory. I can access. Okay. So 89. So she has a better helmet. And then Vicar Max. 77. Or 84. Okay. And none of them lead to level up right now, so... what about the armor they're wearing? 81? 67? 72. Okay, yeah, their armor's still pretty good. I think I've been tinkering it, too. So that might be why it's better. And we have a light assault rifle Mark II. I think I'll keep it like it is. They both have it, light sword. So I should probably get something better for them. But this is pretty good, 576 DPS. That is really good. Oh, and I've been tinkering these up too, I can tell. Okay. Probably should tinker it a little bit more. Whenever possible. Oh. Welcome, Mr. L or M. Kamara, sorry. From OCI Cerebral Committee, subject unacceptable results. So, from Cerebral Committee to OCI Department of Strategic Branding. The OCI Cerebral Committee has hereby decided by unanimous vote that the recent test results from Human Inquiry and Auditing, HIA, are unacceptable, untenable, and unsatisfactory. This message is an informal expression of our dissatisfaction, which will be formally declared by memorandum in the near future. I'm sure they look forward to that. While the committee recognizes the marketing potential of insomnia and chemical dependency, the remaining side effects described in HIA's latest report are incompatible with the OCI's vision of the Adrenatime product. Corporate auditors will expect to see a product that dramatically improves the long-term productivity of Spacer's Choice workers by reducing the need for rest and mitigating the effects of long-term melancholia. The product delivered to HIA induces psychosis, violent behavior, paranoia, and, alarmingly, disobedience. The OCI cannot accept a product that transforms long-term workers into dissidents. The damage to our corporate image will inevitably benefit our rivals at Anticleo. Unanimously, OCI Cerebral Committee. Okay, from L. Goodfellow, subject relax. To my colleagues in the OCI Cerebral Committee, I share your concerns, but not your alarm. In times like these, I encourage you to recall a passage from our Spacer's Choice User Manual. The failures of subordinates must never become the failures of leadership. Scum chapter... Oh, Spacer's Choice User Manual spells out scum. Interesting. Scum chapter 21, article 14. The meaning is simplicity itself. HIA has failed to deliver acceptable results because they have failed to perform their professional obligations. My esteemed colleagues, you and I possess a number of low... Oh, sorry. I thought we were talking about that guy low. Law-given qualifications, but we have not been relegated to lab coat work. Let me reiterate, we are not test tube jockeys, we are leaders. HIA's purpose is to deliver test results. Our purpose is to deliver a quarterly report. I'd like you to reach out to Miriam Kumara at Strategic Branding. Have her team clean up HIA's report. Trim the fat and tuck in the guts. Make it look presentable for our auditors. To OCI Cerebral Committee, subject data presentability and empirical hygiene, from L. Goodfellow. Oh no, from M. Kumara, CCL Goodfellow. Cerebral Committee, my team and I have finished reviewing HIA's latest experimental report. We believe the failure of this report is manifest in its flagrant disregard for company-approved language. To that end, we have drafted a revised report edited with language consistent with the Spacer's Choice company vision. The HIA's original report mentions clear evidence of dangerous side effects associated with using the Adrenotime product, including but not limited to paranoia, violent confusion, chemical dependence, and dissonant adjacent behavior. We propose the following connotative revisions. 1. Dangerous side effects. Exciting collateral benefits. Are they saying that we should call these... refer to paranoia, as dramatically heightened attention? Oh my god. 2. Violent confusion, physically assertive behavior. 4. Chemical dependence, metabolic compatibility. Yeah, that does not equate. 5. Dissonant adjacent behavior. Any mention of dissonant behavior in this report may encourage dissonance. Recommend cutting this phrase entirely out of respect for our readers. Oh boy.